Okay, so that makes more sense because usually the attacker usually chooses Seleucids after Egypt is banned. Because anybody that leaves Egypt for their opponent has to be a pretty bad player. So, Seleucids is like the next best option. That or Rome or something. Alright, transition. Hello, Mr. Eagle. Are you going towards the winner of this battle or the loser? That's the question. Well, I guess everybody's paranoid of taking pikes again. Yeah. Because Royal Peltas annihilate hoplites, but who knows? Who knows? He did bring slingers, so it's not a really rush-oriented army. If he didn't bring those slingers, then I would put my money on Zeke too. But he has to protect them. You know, a lot of people waste their time protecting their skirmishers, so I feel like you place your bets on Zeke. I'm gonna place my bets on Agony Red, just because he brought more cav and all. Yeah, true. Plus, hoplites don't stand a chance against those elephants. Well, wait, but he didn't bring cataphracts. He brought the Agma cavalry, so it's slightly. Yeah, it's fine. I think it's more balanced. Since he brought those extra two cavalry units, he can actually have a better chance. Yeah, that does change a lot of things. Camel spearmen as well, I guess he thought. Macedon would take skirmishers, which is doubtful. But still, the melee fight will go in Seleucid's favor. Yeah, if he uses the elephants on the hoplites and doesn't waste his time for a cav fight, then he can win. But, I don't know. I feel like Agony Red is gonna play smarter. He knows what to do, I hope. Yeah, these are shield bearers. Why didn't he just take, cheap pikes or something. Just to, like, hold them down in some areas or to counter the elephants. I mean, just taking one or two pikes, it doesn't hurt that much. They're cheap. Yeah, they are good. I know that. Everybody knows that. I don't know, I just feel like if Seleucids stay together and don't split up, then he has this. If Red just somehow takes out his cav, then I don't know, he could do a number on those Royal Peltas as they're trying to engage these hoplites. How's the stream so far? How's the quality? Audio, visual, not laggy, is it pixelated? Do I sound like a squirrel? Okay, don't answer that. I know I sound like a squirrel. Alright, you put your money on Zeke, I put my money on Red. Aren't we Dude, we are the worst teammates ever. I sound like a 13-year-old. Awesome! That makes me sound younger. I'm a young boy. Thank you. Dude, we are the worst teammates ever. We're both rooting for the opposite player. Yeah, of course I want Zeke to win because he's my teammate, but. Not my teammate, my clanmate. But still, though. He went against my beliefs, okay? He said Rome 1 players, micro a lot better than Shogun 2 players. So far, they're not doing too good in Rome 2, so yeah. Like last week, there was a. I forgot the 1v1 tournament, the Flesh tournament. Like all Rome 1 players lost in the first round. That was laughable. Well, in Rome 1, Rome 1 does require more micro. I admit that. But Shogun 2 requires more tactical advantages, positions, formations, and whatnot, a lot more than Rome. Did I do that? That was stupid. Whoa. He's gonna get a nice charge. Zeke made a really big mistake. He's gonna keep on moving his infantry as Red is gonna charge him. Pretty good. Good so far. Now he's gonna charge in. These two are gonna be blobbed up against the... Oh, no, he's gonna split them. Good. Good so far. Decent hits. Slingers are supporting. Cav fight. He's definitely gonna win the cav fight. Zeke. But what are these elephants doing? Shield barriers trying to go out to the elephants and the cav. Cav are getting caught on the elephants, so that's a big mistake. Already losing 1 year. The movement's going on back here. Up. That one up. Late trample going down, but still nice charges. See who has the better advantage. Seleucids winning. Elephants are going to go in there, win that. Here's a better position. Sorry about that. General gonna go through, gonna get caught by the Seleucids. Oh, devastating. He's gonna go right in between the gap, go for the skirmishers. Doing pretty good on the center. Man, these shield bearers are actually holding on. I'm actually starting to see a lot of blinking Seleucid flags. Only three. One disappears, doing really well in the center. These skirmishers are pretty much dead. Yeah, I think Agony Red has this. I told you. Where's my money? I told you. No, you can't change your vote. You can't Belgium bastard. Yeah, he made that micro mistake. He was moving his infantry and... Seriously, why do you move on the side when there's an army right in front of you? I would move back to readjust or regroup or something, but... You know he lost because... Red... I don't know. I mean, Red won the cav fights, and he's already doing a number on these Royal Peltas, and there's only skirmishers left. So he's going to kill them, mop them up, then focus on the Royal Peltas. One Royal Peltas, one over here... Holy crap. Even against 3 against 2 units, Red is still winning. See, the Kev came in handy, man. Yeah, he attacked. He took the initiative while he was disorganized. While Zeke was disorganized. That's why he won, mainly. And it's still kind of close, but I still say Red has this, because... He has the infantry advantage now, even though at the very start he was at a disadvantage, because, you know, swords kill spears. Yep, Agony prevails now. Hey, I voted for Agony Red, and I seriously wanted him to beat Zeke in the first place anyway, just because he was disrespecting the Shogun 2 community. Pressure getting to who? Zeke or Red? And he concedes. Who would have known? Hoplites beat Royal Peltas. Dude, you know Zeke is very mad at the moment. You know he's very mad at the moment. Alright, now I'm rooting for Zeke. I mean, the first game, sure, why not? Red attacked and rushed, and I like that of most players. I respect that. Plus, he was Macedon against Seleucid, so naturally I would root for the underdog. And you lost the vote, and I get to tell Agony Red this. Actually, the stream is enough proof of that.